mind listening to some Hong Kong style singers. Yeah, I tried. And thank you for coming. It's a great honor for me to present my first directed movie here. Okay, and now let the movie talk to you first, and we talk after the screening. Thank you.
Mr. Director Lau actually didn't get his visa until Thursday, so the moment he found out that he got his visa that allowed him to come to the U.S., he went right to Guangzhou, got the visa on Thursday, and flew over here the next day, so...
Stick around afterwards for the Q&A. Is there anything else? Any other business?
Nope.
Ladies and gentlemen, it is two
thank yous for the film. I saw you thanked a lot of the old Cinema City people, like Teddy Robin and John Chung. These guys? Teddy Chen, sorry. John Chung.
Yes.
Is that John Chung?
Yes.
What did he do for the film?
Well, he gave me so many ideas when in the post-production.
Really?
Yes.
So he's still involved with film?
Yes, of course.
Really? Anyways, okay, questions that are less nerdy. So how did you cast the movie? Because it's a great cast. Can you talk a little bit about your four lead actors?
I need help.
Yeah, please.
So originally, what he had in mind is to find four actors who are basically middle-aged, you know, kind of up there in age, not young actors, but they have to be good physically fit. The idea is that at this age, at the middle age, like, you know, people in their 40s, when you're still physically fit, you haven't given up on life. You still think that you can achieve a lot of things. You can still accomplish a lot of things.
But so how did you come to cast Mark Chang? Right. But were you a fan of his? Did you?
Yeah, he's a fan of one of my producers.
Okay. And then Francis Aiden?
You mean how I found him?
How you found him, what they were like to work with. Why these four guys? Hong Kong has so many actors, so many middle-aged actors, so many old actors. So you had to give them like a physical exam? They had to take off their shirt?
Look
like a model. Okay.
It's very important.
Who decided on Simon Yam's wig?
Oh, we decide together. He tell me he want to have a different hairstyle. And he want to act like...
If you want to
act like African American.
So the first reference I give him to see is Samuel L. Jackson.
I feel like in all of his movies now, he has a very different hairstyle. Is this very important to Simon?
So he actually had a discussion with Felix Chang, you know, the Hong Kong director, during the planning of this film. And I guess during the discussion with Felix, they realized one very important thing. When they are casting or when they're thinking of making a movie, before coming up with a story or before finalizing the story, coming up with the characterization is actually the more important aspect of filmmaking.
So you're mostly famous for being a screenwriter before this.
It's okay.
Well, it's how you pay your rent, right? Screenwriting?
Of course, I write a script for a living, yes.
Yes. So how did you get a chance to direct?
Thank you.
So he's been, you know, writing screenplays for 14 years. So because of his long experience writing screenplays, he's earned the respect and trust of a lot of financiers and producers who really think that, well, you know, you really should direct, you really should make a film on your own. So to them, they have no, they're fully confident in him becoming a director. It's more like they're actually waiting for him to decide, okay, now I'm gonna direct.
So the first day on the set, how'd you feel? Nervous?
First day of filming is so chaotic. There's so many things going on. So chaotic. He doesn't even know. Like he didn't even know to be feared and to have fear. He's not even scared because there's so many things going on. So he's not worried or he's not feeling scared until after the first day of filming.
The first day shooting is the bowling scene. I shoot that day over 100 shots. It's too chaotic that day.
Did you write this script
to
direct?
Yes.
Only was this an idea you had for a long time?
Yes.
The fake cops. Yes. Did you always? Because your other scripts are not. This feels almost like a cartoon. You know, the style is very big, very colorful. The other movies made from your scripts are not like this at all. Was this a style you really wanted to work in a long time, or did it just happen by accident?
This is my style, I think.
This, yeah.
Before I write the script for the other director, I'm serve them. So I think this is the first script that is 100% is my idea.
Where did this idea come from? What was first? The roaches, the fake policeman, the minibus? What idea came to you first?
It's a very long story.
So many years, I used to be a reporter many years ago. So at that time, I went to U.S. and I went to Hollywood and you know, watched a lot of movies. So doing interviews, you know, like I used to do press interviews in Hollywood. So doing those interview sessions, they're going to be different table for different press. There's one table for American press, one table for European press, one table for, say, Latin American, like from Argentina, and then there's this one table where all the reporters at that table speak very little English. So I befriended this Argentinian reporter, so besides talking about soccer, which we both love, the one other common thing that we had, you know, that we both liked was movies, so we talked a lot about movies. So he asked me a very interesting question. He said, is Hong Kong really chaotic? Because all, you know, I see a lot of Hong Kong movies. All I see are cops, robbers, and triad members. So it was at that time that I realized, oh, so these three elements are the main thing that Hong Kong movies are known for. So when I started writing screenplay, I realized that I need to know these three elements, you know, in more detail. So it's easy to know about, like, you know, cops, what the world's like. It's easy to know what triad members are like in their world. But it's very hard to know what robbers, you know, like, what are the mindset or what are the world where robbers live in. So one time I was watching this, you know, like a cop thriller with a triad leader.
So
there's one scene where the cops are there to capture a gang leader. And the triad leader whom I was watching a movie with got really excited over that scene. I was surprised. I said, well, why are you so excited about this scene? You know, in this scene, they're catching you.
So
And then his response was actually kind of interesting. He said, whenever one's watching, you know, these kind of movies, you know, cop versus thieves, the people who are most interested or who are more, you know, totally involved in this kind of films are usually cops.
那一刻我就開始想啦，其實有可能係電影令到大家有正義感，又或者如果我搞一個故事係一班賊扮差人，然之後結果佢哋做咗差人要做嘅嘢，可能係幾有趣嘅一件事。
So then I realized in movies, people realize that, you know, they can find justice, the idea of justice can be found in movies. And that's when the idea that came to me that what if I made a movie about a bunch of robbers, a group of robbers who disguised as cops to rob and they ended up doing things that real cops actually were doing. So I found that very interesting. I think that would be an intriguing concept for a movie.
So that is the starting point of this movie.
So where did the idea for the roaches come from?
Sensitive topic. Some of you
know.
Actually, my main point is that these coaches is kind of like a representation of these four people, and the idea is to express the fact that sometimes the most useless insect, like cockroaches, can end up being the most effective or most useful.
So
the, you know, the last four cockroaches in the end scene is my, you know, what I'm trying to express is, you know, these cockroaches might be scum, but they ended up being heroes.
From the time you wrote the script to the time you finished the film, how long was this?
You start from the script.
Yeah, like how long did this movie take to get from?
About 3.5 years.
And what was the budget around?
Not including the actor's fee, their salary, the cost, the budget for the movie was 10 million Hong Kong dollars, which is around 1.3 million US.
When you look at the film now, what is the part you're happiest with?
Well, I'm not very happy with it.
what do you see? Do you want to change things? Do you?
For example, this time I especially concentrate in the English subtitle. Oh, I really think I can do better.
But as a director, what did you sort of learn from this that next time you're going to do differently?
So let me use my recent experience as an example. So right now I'm actually working with the great Johnny To.
He's amazing on the location. And after I work with him, I found I'm too stupid in directing a movie. Because what he doing is a director must do. So I learned so much from him. And I am sure next time I can do much better.
Let's take some questions from the